Right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to game one of this finals series here for the Zotac Cup Masters European number three qualifier. I think this is number three. It certainly is series one. So two teams have already made it through to that first regional. This is a seat in that middle ground, the regional, and then the regionals go into the LAN. Don't confuse yourself. This is not for a seat in the LAN, but a lot of open portions to this tournament. There are 24 opens total, I think, for the entire thing. A couple of them have happened already, so there might be about 20 left, but there's a lot in each region, North America, South America, Europe, and Asia. So some guaranteed South American action here, at least in the regional qualifiers. I'm Sayori. I'll have Mott with me momentarily here. He's going to hop on. We've got Slice and Dice versus HFZ, the two teams that made it all the way. Spirit made it to the semifinals, getting knocked out. And we also saw the No Logic Gaming, the Excalibur, J4, Mitch Milan squad also get knocked out in the semifinals. Best of ones all the way here. This is the first and only best of three series of this bracket. Moondeck TV going to be bringing you the action for all of these opens, at least for the finals of such. So a lot of action to look forward to if you want to follow the tournament. There is a link below the Twitch stream for all that delicious Zotac detail stuff. Okay, so we got Mott coming on here. Keeper of the Light, first pick for Slice and Dice.
Is this the right mic? It is. Okay, we're good.
I hope so. Yes, okay.
Phew.
You know, I was worried about that.
Wait, so
Slice and Dice had first pick here.
Whoa.
They took the Coddle.
You're telling me No Logic lost?
They did. We didn't see it because we couldn't spectate my boys' game.
What just happened? How do they both lose? How did Spirit and No Logic both lose these teams?
I don't know, man.
Best of ones or something, I guess.
Well, that is definitely an aspect. Team Spirit. Definitely felt that best of one action. Just lost one big team fight. We saw a couple of diebacks, and we did catch the tail end of that game. And my God, man, it was tough for Spirit fans. So a lot of meta action happening here. Seen Darkseer in the games that I was checking out earlier in the bracket. He was getting a lot of love. Of course, Monkey King, the talk of the town, one of the more annoying position four roamers.
I'm wondering if like Magnus is going to continue to get banned after patch 7.04, where they changed his cooldown for his RP, but his empower is still very strong, and they already have a jug, so I feel like if you want to pick him for HFZ, you absolutely can. I mean, I feel like that's, what else do they have?
No, it's a classic combo. I mean, we've seen like the Magnus Ogre jug kind of commonly buff up the big boy, let him take out some ancients.
Yeah, where is Ogre too? Did they nerf him? Did they change Ogre in the patch? I don't think they really changed him.
I didn't really digest that.
I don't think they changed Ogre in that last patch.
But I don't think he was seriously changed.
I don't think so either. So that's another hero. Like, Jug, along with either Mag or Ogre, could be very strong. They already have the Disruptor, so if you really, like, Disruptor plays that hard 5, you play the Ogre as the 4 if you want, maybe. I mean, Ogre could play 5, too.
Yeah, they need to be a little careful, though, because this could be position 1 Venge. A lot of teams have been doing that, so Slice and Dice could do a crazy 5-man Death Ball-type deal before your empowered Jug is really ready to do a hell of a lot, but at the same time, it is just a straight damage buff. You know, it helps with Omni Slash. It kind of compounds the damage he does with his ult. 5 seconds
remaining. Yeah.
So, some options. And the Invoker ban. Slice and Dice limiting the mid picks. Shadow Fiend and Invoker. And a bunch of offlaners banned out here by HFZ. Sand King. Legion Commander is the big boy.
There he is.
Offlane Centaur. All right.
Centaur, yeah. You keep forgetting about those. I mean, there's still offlanes for Slice and Dice to make, too. But Centaur is just like,
it's sick with Disruptor.
The only thing they changed is that it's the 10%. It's like 40% now instead of 50%. So they've now, since the last few patches, it used to be 60%. They've gone down 20% in terms of damage reduction from Aghanim Scepter Centaur Ultimate.
Yeah.
So that's the only change. And I think the hero is still very good in the early game with a Blink Dagger. As long as you get that Blink early, you're fine. They'll pick up Rubick, though. And so they have some good steals against this team. Stampede, Stomp, Disruptor, or anything from him, really.
Yeah,
so
I love Stampede with Disruptor, though. It lets you close the gap to get those glimpses off, maybe find some extra pickoffs.
And you also called it, too. You were mentioning Venge Carry, and that seems to be what it's going to be. And then the Warlock pick as well. So
you're right. With the Rubick, it's almost guaranteed here to be a position 1 Venge.
Yeah, which is totally fine. The amount of damage she does in the early game is so strong. The thing is, though, her Hurricane Plague, if she goes for it first, it does cost a bit more now, so it'll take a bit longer.
Yeah. 10 seconds remaining. Yeah, I noticed that, dude. That was one of those patch changes where I was playing a Terrorblade, and I'm like, holy shit.
500, huh?
It doubled the cost.
They doubled the shit out of that cost, for sure.
That's a pretty big one. So Warlock now, a lot of sustain for the Dire squad.
Real quick before we continue on the draft, I do want to point out that for those of you that are familiar with the CIS region, Tame My Wild is actually on HFZ, which is the Dire team, as well as COT.
Which one is XX?
XX, I believe, might be Tame My Wild. I'm pretty sure that's it. And then Roddick, I think. It was in a lobby.
Rome is COT.
Yeah.
So, I don't know who S1B is, though.
Yeah, there's some names that are familiar. There's some that aren't. Now they go to the Abaddon. He was changed to, I think his base strength was nerfed. I'm not sure 100% about that, though. But
interesting. Well, they've got pretty crazy early game here for Slice and Dice. Abaddon, some amazing survivability. Lets your position one Venge be even more aggressive. You know, you've got a great supporting cast around her. You've got Blinding Lights with mana leaks. You've got telekinesis is from the Rubick. Like, there are a lot of ways to peel for this Venge if she gets jumped on, and then healing, cleansing from the big boy.
Yeah, I like Abaddon against Jug too. I feel like with the Phonic Shield, it makes him feel slightly more useless than he is already. I mean, he's not useless. I should say he's slightly more difficult to play.
I feel like Slice and Dice need kind of a high tempo mid though, something that can scale but also come online early. And I'm not sure what. I think Invoker would have been a good choice.
I was
if
thinking
they
Mag
gone
still.
For it.
I'm still thinking Mag, but they don't have a
for Slice and Dice.
Yeah, but they don't. That's the reason why I wouldn't say Mag is because they don't have that like Jug or PA carry or whatever, so maybe
I guess the thing with position one Venge is damage isn't her problem,
right?
So like
exactly.
For Jug, he used to go Battle Fury and now he doesn't, so it feels like almost a free item on him. And
that's a great ban, by the way.
Yeah,
the
I think
ban.
The Alc ban is good. A lot of good Aghanim's upgrades this game, all of them very very
take
strong
control of the game too, as well, just like split push stuff like that, you have to deal with it. And I'm just trying to figure out, like, I thought Invoker would have been great for either team, but
no, Alc is a good ban here.
What else is there? There's a lot that I'm just forgetting at this point. Like that could go mid. Ember Spirit maybe if you're Slice and Dice or for HFZ.
Okay, I could see an Ember working.
I mean,
for the Radiant.
That's like the go to now. It got banned. So much
okay,
for that.
They banned it themselves though. So they
it was good for both teams, I think.
Yeah, I mean, if they wanted it, they would have had the choice.
I'm wondering what they're gonna pick here. I still think, again, if you're
is
HFC,
Puck,
you could go Mag.
I don't know if Puck scales
Puck,
enough.
Puck, Puck also did get buffed. I think his base damage was increased by 3 in this last patch as well. So if you want to go Puck, I think that's not a bad idea. Theoretically, you'd like to have somebody that works well with the Keeper of the Light, in terms of recall and stuff like that. But then you'd have that hero mid. I guess you could theoretically do PL mid.
I mean, they could do something like a Shadow Fiend.
Also, Jug could be mid for HFC. So there's like a lot of like, this is a very open-ended draft, I think, for both teams. Shadow Fiend was banned, so that's taken out.
Oh, whoops. Tinker? I don't know. Like, I don't know exactly what Slice and Dice likes to play. So some of this is a
if this was
you know,
if this
a style
was an IP,
choice.
If this was an IP, I'd say absolutely they would pick Tinker because of Quakefa. But
OD also still an option.
Actually, that's huge. I forgot about OD.
He can
completely.
Be pretty good with the five man. You know,
OD,
the mana
sniper,
aura.
OD or sniper are pretty good late dominators if they want those.
Yeah. I mean, Queen of Pain, much less conventional, but also something that can scale. Also, come online early with good team fight.
We're throwing out a lot of mid heroes here, but I think that we've hit some good ones, and I'd be surprised if we haven't already discussed the hero they pick.
Yeah,
I guess you could fifth pick Meepo. Now it's TA.
Okay, they take TA.
All right, well.
Well, minus armor goes well with the Venge. This gives Radiant side some pretty solid Roche control now, though. You know, you get vision in the pit. You've got minus armor.
Yeah. If you could do it early enough, too. Oh, there it is.
Whoa.
Well, I said it. Fifth pick Meepo coming out, but it was for HFZ instead.
Wah, 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 wah.
That is kind of rough. a lot of these heroes are going to get blown away, I think, by the Meepo if you're not careful, especially when it gets Blink Dagger. Abaddon is still very strong, but... Meepo Warlock is like a very good combo with like the heroes they already have.
So this is one of these drafts where I look at Slice and Dice and it's like, what's the win condition? Their early game is pretty good, but their sieging isn't amazing. So they're not going to be able to close this game out before 35 minutes or something.
I think it's one TA. If they can get A, just get a Desolator on TA if they want to go down that route. I mean, they could go early Blink too, which I think is
I mean, you look at high ground defense from Dire, it's quite good with Warlock, Disruptor, Centaur,
well,
even
the
Jug.
Same for Radiant too with Keeper of the Light.
Yeah, so then my brain goes, all right, well, how about towards the late game, who's scaling better? And ultra late game, I think it definitely goes to Dire. You've got Jug and Meepo. You've got the, you know, potential double Warlock ult that goes through BKB.
Static Storm, you know,
like,
Agonim
Scepter. Yeah, all of these heroes scale very well. Even like Centaur compared to the offlaner Slice and Dice and the Abaddon. I think Centaur might scale a little bit better. So, and they're also going to hit this timing where Meepo will be capped out at, what is it, like 30 minutes, 35 minutes?
He'll have some real good items.
A good game, he'll be huge. And that, I think, will be the timing where Venge will start to be falling off and Meepo will still be on that upward trajectory, and this will be hard.
So I think you and I are both on the same page then with the Dire team in terms of which draft we like more. I always feel like whenever I see a fifth pick Meepo, it usually is pretty game-winning. There's very few games where I see a fifth pick Meepo and I'm like, well, that's not that good.
Yeah. You know? I mean, as always with Meepo, it comes down to execution.
Damn, they are some Battle Cup winners, man, let me tell you.
Holy shit.
Yeah, they really are. Slice and Dice, they've won a few Battle Cups in their time. HFZ, they're like, we don't got time for that. Time to jump into the game, Andrew. It's a best-of-three series. Oh, they didn't add the best-of-three marker up in the top row.
Oh, nor.
It's like the thing that triggers me the most.
Oopsie.
Are you on your Steam? Because
I am on my Steam.
I was going to be afraid you were using my settings.
Nope, we're good. I've got my hotkeys nice and default here. None of this stupid 1-2-3 bullshit. but yeah, so it's always about execution with Meepo. I think there is a window for our Radiant squad, the Slicers and Dicers, to maybe capitalize at that 10 to 15, 15 to 20 minute window when TA has that first item. You know, maybe she gets a fast Desolator or a fast Blink. Venge is really online. If they whiff one Warlock ult, right, if they can win one team fight in that window, they could start to take control of the map and maybe starve this out.
And the question is, too, how are they going to set up the lanes? Because if you're aggressive enough, you could shut down the Centaur. You could maybe start at least harassing the people early and shut down the Jug. You could have a very good early game. It's all about snowballing, as you mentioned, I think, for this Radiant team. They have very good snowball potential, but the Meepo should find farm regardless. It's more of shutting down the side laners. And I think they're going to dual in both lanes. They will send the Warlock down bottom, it looks like, with the Centaur, so he actually should be fine because he has Shadow Word now to heal him up.
Mm-hmm.
So they might have some trouble with the Jug top with the Abaddon Coddling, which I think is what it's going to be. That's how they're setting it up now.
He's got the Immortal Backpack, dude.
Is that really it?
Very experienced. It's got an empty socket, though, so I don't know about that.
Yeah, they're going to do pretty well here. Is that Tame My Wild? It might be, actually, on the Meepo.
Did they actually get a counter ward when I was looking at cosmetics? That sentry's down, and I don't see a second observer for the Radiant. Is there one hiding somewhere?
No, there was a counter ward. You were right.
So I think Radiant lost one of their wards trying to block out the camp here.
Yeah.
So this is a nice start for the Dire. They'll get a ward into the jungle here, and a lane ward up top. Very interesting spot for that ward. I have not seen that one too
much. It should still cover the TP and like the lane ward for the tower. It should still be fine. It's not like anything.
It goes all the way up to the tower.
It's just going to be able to see the TP's in. Looks like there's some action happening. But this is going to be a tough lane for the Meepo until he gets his level 3 and gets his clones out. So he should still struggle a bit. Telekinesis, Jafar already taking harass. Shadow Word with the Centaur, he did get stomped first. He doesn't have return, which means that it's a little bit easier for the Rubick to harass. But considering it's a dueling for both of these teams, I would be very shocked if they could get a kill down bottom with the Radiant team. For Dire, I think they just want to farm. I don't think they really want to try to go for a kill or anything. But
yeah, kind of interesting to see 2-on-2 come out of both sides. But you're right about the Warlock Centaur. This is a lot of sustainability. You know, Centaur already very beefy. Once he gets returned,
maybe they can get a kill here. They need the Fade Bolt for the Rubick, and even then,
if
Shadow Word is up, I don't think he can get the kill.
Hard to find kills at level 1. Back towards mid, TA, Meepo. Pretty even. Meepo cutting the lane. Very aggressive positioning, but so far, so good.
He has a salve. He should be okay. He's dove pretty deep. Refraction's up. And 2 or 3 more auto attacks should do the job. He can salve here. He was very close. He's just going to harass back salve was used, but
knows his limits, though. Very impressive.
Yeah.
It's a lot of farm out of that. Now 7-1 compared to the 4-3 TA.
I mean, it's very good. It's only like a minute and a half into the game, but it's still a pretty good start for the Dire.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, and they it's all about, I feel like, snowballing for this Radiant team, stopping the Centaur from getting farmed.
And it's also half the battle for the Meepo, right? Like, these early levels are the hardest. Once you get that second Meepo, things get a lot easier, and that's where TA needs to be a little more defensive.
Oh, they got the kill on the Centaur. I'm so actually shocked.
They went
1-for-1. Magic Missile Wave of Tear with Rubick Telekinesis is enough damage, but
yeah.
I thought with Shadow Word up, it might have been better. But he's actually out of mana, so maybe that's it.
So the first blood goes to the Warlock, but Jafar gets the counter kill onto the Centaur.
All right. Well, still farming well. The Meepo and the Jug. 12 lashes for Meepo, 11 for the Jug. Meepo, I think, should be out of his clone pretty soon.
You know, Maw, remind me after this game, we should turn on the net worth indicator. Why don't I have that on?
Yeah.
I just have to set up the.
I should always set that up, but I never remember how to do it. I think I know how to do it on the browser source, but.
You got to copy the link, though, from one of the other presentations. Yeah. I don't have that handy.
Yeah. It should be. I don't know, actually. Zest moved about it.
Yeah. So, anyway, aside from that exchange down bottom, now turning into sort of a quiet early game. Centaur getting some alone time as his Warlock pokes around for the rune. Oh, looks like he's just going to stack up.
Yeah, he's good to go. Okay. Meepo now in the jungle, so they should give some experience to somebody mid. And it looks like that might be the Disruptor. We'll see, though. XX might just go back to lane for a bit until he uses the jungle. So that's when he thought he was going to get some experience mid, potentially. This is still not an easy lane, all things considered, for the Meepo, even with two clones. But if he can set something up with the Disruptor, they can find a kill there.
Yeah. It becomes just a factor of the jungle as well. Once you have two, you can find those rotations. You know, take out the stacked camps. And that becomes an important recovery tool for the Meepo.
I think a lot of it is also poofing out the waves mid and then just heading to the jungle so you're not missing anything, you know. And if you are, the Disruptor's getting it too. But this is going to leave the Jug in a solo lane. They don't have any disables, but if he's
farming real well, though. I mean, number one on CS.
Yeah, he's doing great, but this might be tough. If he gets illuminated and then they just run at him with the Abad and he won't be able to find as much. Meanwhile, bottom, they need to be careful. Stomp should be coming out for Radix. Telekinesis just in time, and Jafar actually should get out of trouble, but still the Shadow are ticking down. They tried going to work. Cod taking a lot of damage on this Warlock. This Rubick is getting some good harass. Speaking of which, he gets double-edged. And so all of a sudden, both of those heroes, the Rubick and the Venge, are extraordinarily low in HP.
Such an annoying combo here. Centaur can just spam that out as much as he wants with the heals from the Warlock. And there's really nothing you can do against it. It has a surprising amount of range also. You feel like it's melee range, but has that little circle. It's pretty easy for him to get in your face and get the damage off.
Oh. He can't. Cool. I don't know if he could do anything here.
Next
no
to
mana.
The shrine, yeah, this is pretty.
He's just going to scout out and see that they are shrining. They're going to see Jiang as well. I think he actually missed out on the TA shrining up, but he just knew that it was like, okay, well, I don't need to be in this position right now.
Yeah. Always good to have the confirmation.
I think this game, early game, is going better, despite the first blood is going better for the Dire, but you still at least have the farming bad top lane.
Yeah, I mean, experience advantage for the Dire, as you'd expect with the Meepo. Madden.
He's a raindrop too.
He's still doing surprisingly well. Like, you know, you'd think that this Juggernaut alone would struggle. I mean, now falling behind a little bit in CS would definitely be helpful if he had a Warlock up here to zone for him. You can see the Illuminate starting to tick him down, going through these raindrop charges pretty fast.
Yeah. Now this is still a pretty good early game. Meepo wants to get that Dragonlance, that Blink Dagger, and then they'll start maybe fighting with those two items. Maybe even with the Dragonlance, they can start getting involved.
Yeah, and here's the efficiency rotation. Meepo heads into the jungle. Yep. Disruptor gets some alone time mid. Yep. Has to stay defensive in the lane, but the solo experience
he's
so
gonna
important
get the
here.
Creep Wave's about to push in, and they're not going to die for it, so he's going to get some experience, maybe even some CS out of it too.
Yeah.
Getting to that level 6 is huge for pretty much everybody in this game, especially the Warlock and the Disruptor. Level 3 for him, so it's going to be a while. He's kind of been stacking and just making sure they have farm. But they're going to be able to farm elsewhere. Radic has, I think, got a Quelling Blade. He's also building it into Tranquils on the Centaur. But Blade Fury top. He's level 4, so he does have level 2 Aphotic. But here comes the Meepo. He's going to try to TP out. Earthbind is there. Poof. And then one more auto attack. He was so close to completing that TP. You actually heard the sound of the TP completion happen before he died.
Yeah,
that's
that was
huge.
Really close.
Big kill for Meepo.
Yep, the snowball gets rolling. 2-1. Not a high kill score, but a great rotation. And right now, he's just happy to farm the jungle. That's extra money on top. Number one on net worth very comfortably.
Man.
And Disruptor getting more alone time here.
Oh, Abaddon dies top two, it looks like.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I think he got a solo with an Omni Slash. Omni. He didn't have borrowed time. It was only like level 4 or 5 or something.
He's only level 4. Sorry about that, folks. But big kill for the Jug. So this was already going well for Dire. Now with those kills added on top, 1,500 net worth, nearly 2,500 experience.
Good glimpse. He's not going to die for this. Very good glimpse.
He'll be fine.
So this is going great for Dire now. And it's 5th pick Meepo could be troublesome. They're going to jump back. Magic Missile. Radic is still pretty tanky. No Stampede, though. Gets body blocked. They need a couple more auto attacks to do the job. Now they're chasing after the Warlock, which would be not the best kill in terms of if they wanted to get the Centaur, it's a better way to stop him from getting that early hood.
Yeah, these right clicks, though, man. Nasty with that Venge aura.
Oh, he has a Blightstone, too, with the Wave of Terror, which is, I think, pretty interesting.
Yeah.
One Aquila as well.
Not a minus armor. Quite nice. Pressure definitely on the Radiant side, though, to make something happen. They know Meepo's farming the jungle, and he'll start to pull ahead just naturally over time. So in the next 5 minutes or so, we'll probably see them start to group up, maybe five-man a little earlier than usual. Abaddon, he gets the phase boots.
I was wondering if they were going to do this. The Meepo's rotated bottom, but they're going to have Stampede pretty soon. But he actually just walks out and dies.
Yeah, he doesn't have Stampede yet. They catch him as he was coming out of the tree line.
He had a TP scroll. He just didn't want to use it. That's kind of greedy.
Very greedy. I think he just wanted to get over to the shrine. He has infused raindrops, too. Took a couple charges off.
I think what they want to do is they want to have this Meepo be aggressive with Stampede. He's not six yet. But they could still find... Oh, God, this Rubick is mega dead. They don't even have to poof. The Venge already TP'd out, though. I think he knew something was coming, so...
Absolutely. Nice double stack, maybe a triple stack here for Meepo. So he'll start clearing out the enemy jungle.
Thank you. I will take that.
This is...
It's starting to look a little bad, but that's kind of how it's supposed to look when you're against Meepo, I suppose, at this point in the game.
Well, that's true, but... I mean, we're only 8 minutes in, and he's already picked up two very easy rotations. This is just the beginning. I mean, he doesn't even have any items yet. The Dragonlance is on the way.
Yeah, it's done. And a 400 extra gold on top of that, I think.
Yep, there it is.
Man, this is going to be a very quick Blink Dagger. The Healing Ward is up. No Omni Slash. He has enough mana for it with that. Now they're going to use the Static Storm instead, and this is going to be a kill. Yeah, not level 6 yet. And now he needs to be careful. He's very close to that Omni Slash. He just used the Mango, though, for the mana, so he has to back up now.
Yep, Rubick close down bottom. Man. Looks like... Oh, no, that's TA and Meepo just traded mid as that was happening. Yeah. Holy shit. This is a weird game. There's a lot of 1v1 kills.
Yeah, kills you wouldn't expect happening.
I guess TA dove there as that fight was going to... Oh, my God. Mod, I missed like half the kills this game. What the fuck is going on, dude? What is happening?
This game's getting clown town real quick.
My God. All right, I got to zone in here, dude. I'm in it to win it. Here we go. Radek, he's under pressure. He does have Stampede, though, so he should be just fine. Jafar has swap.
Stampede, swap out of range. Level 1 swap. Low.
That was close, though. He was almost in range right before he hit the Stampede.
Yeah. But that's used defensively. That's kind of a win, actually.
And cleansing fakes.
After they get that kill on Meepo, the TA is doing well. The Venge is doing well. So
it's a definitely sign of recovery for the TA. I'm really curious what item he goes for. Like, you rush the Blink Dagger.
He's going Desolator. He knows that. Deso, yeah, there it push is. Early on, I think.
I mean, that's a great item to get the snowball rolling for TA because you just have so much burst damage.
Yeah. Well, it's Meepo. Dead Rubick, probably. I
think
would say.
So. Come the poofs, and that's another easy pick off for the Meepster.
You just can't, like, he was going to ward, I think. I'm pretty sure he had a ward on him, on the Rubick.
Oh, Coddle doesn't have a point in mana leak. Oh, he's so dead. TP out. Omni. Nope.
He's good to go. He's fine. That was a great TP.
Okay, he's good.
All right, so they're starting to get their level 6s. The only one that doesn't have it on the side of the Dire is the Warlock. I think he's like level 4 or 5 at this point. Mm-hmm. But yeah, just farming, getting the Hood of Defiance. He's already got the Cloak, so he's getting pretty close to the Hood for the Centaur. They really want to use Stampede aggressively, I think.
So I mean, the ideal scenario, yeah. Bob, glimpse back.
You are mega dead. You already used your TP. There's absolutely no way out of this.
Sorry, Coddle. Meet your maker.
Get that Illuminate off. Did you get off the Mist Coil? Sigma, does he have level 6 still?
I mean, he takes off another infused raindrop. He gets a little extra value out of it before he dies.
He does. He's so close to 6. Oh my god, are you kidding? That sucks.
Static
Storm as well. If they lose Jafar, it's even worse. They might get the kill on Madden. So it's actually a 2-for-2. So the Meepo died, I think, to the Rubick, who was mid somehow.
Yeah. TA was there too. Looks like he just got telekinesed, bursted down probably as we were watching that other one.
So that's not as bad. They get the kill on the Jug, which I think is an okay trade.
So Meepo not included in this recap, unfortunately.
Yeah, it would be more even if that was
the case. And Centaur pushing down bottom. So if we look at the overall graph, it is still favoring the Dire. TA putting a lot of pressure on this tower, but in comes the Warlock. Try and mount a defense, and he will not be successful. Deny also does not come out.
I don't know, man. I think if Meepo just stays in the jungle and farms more, he might not have that death happen.
I just feel so bad for this Abaddon, dude. Look how close he is to level 5. I wish I could ping. That's got to be one experience.
It is, I'm pretty sure. He just needs to get literally a single creep, like even shared with 3 people. He could still get level 6 off.
Yeah. Up top. Rubick level 9.
He stole Static Storm. Oh, God. He stole Static Storm.
He doesn't have any way to keep him in, though. Does he have the damage? Meepo on the way. Coddle also nearby. Rubick with the Fade Bolt will bring him down. Stampede. Meepo, he might have the damage, and he does. One for one now on the backside. Rubick caught by the Jug, and it's Blade Fury on Blade Fury. Oh, my. It's a nice steal, but Jug still has the right clicks. And it's a two for one. Dire find the advantage.
This is one of the cunningest games like I've ever seen. Just people in like random positions stealing random spells.
Mod, it's Slice and Dice versus HFZ. How dare you?
They're really slicing and dicing, and I guess HFZ are really HFZing.
They are. I mean, believe it or not, though, Jiang has kept up with this Meepo, which is surprising. It looked like Meepo was going to pull ahead.
He's got his Desolator, essentially, after like one or two more camps.
Yeah, a couple of deaths have really set him back, and now TA is actually number one as he starts clearing through the jungle.
As soon as they get this Desolator, they could smoke, get a pick, head to Roche if they want to, or they could just head to Roche, but they want to make sure Stampede is down, especially the Centaur, too.
Looks like Centaur probably pulling for the Blink Dagger first, and then going to pick up the Hooded of Defiance. Classic item on the Centaur, of course.
Yeah, that blink is close if he wants it, but all right, the net worth's back to 1,000 in favor of
closing the gap, dude.
Yeah, this is kind of getting a little sketchier, I think, for
the
hour.
Closing the gap.
But you talked about late game, and now they have Warlock Golem. This is going to be the first fight with Warlock Golem. They spoke up with it, and it looks like they're going to fight mid, potentially. Mm. Oh, God, Jiang would be such a huge kill here. Thunderstrike, they have a glimpse back to
you.
He's
got the Desolator coming. And
Static
it's not going to be there in time.
Oh, good telekinesis, but the Golem has dropped as well. They should have the stomp ready to go on top of that. They'll get the kill. It looks like he's nailed it up, but the Poops will get the job done. It's a double edge, actually. They get the kill, and now they have to back up. They don't want to get too far.
It's a good pick. Good pick. Oh. Double Blink Daggers now. Centaur and the Meepo. Holy Toledo Mod. This is about to get scary for the Radiant. Meet Your Bob gets caught. They'll find the kill there. Sigma gets off the borrowed time. That'll heal him up, but they've got a lot of damage. Stun from Jafar. He wants to get the Disruptor. A few more auto attacks. He'll find that kill, but Meepo is here, and he's doing the big damage. Omni Slash. Maiden jumps across. Double edge. There's only one left.
Good stomp.
Rubick, no. You poor baby. He's out of mana. He's out of life. He will fall. It's a wipe. Dire go 1-for-5. Huge team fight for HFC.
I think Disruptor's like, I'm okay with that. I am fine with that fight. They got 1,500 gold. It was actually 2,000, all things considered. Gold exchange.
A swing. Yeah, look at all that.
It's
going
to be even worse because the tower's probably going to fall. Actually, they're TPing, I think, the TAN.
Wow, they actually want to defend this. TA has the Desolator.
God, the Desolator is doing some serious work. They will get the tower, but can they leave is the question.
Yeah, TA, unfortunately, with this build, very slow. Has no way to close the gap.
No Blink Dagger.
And
oh,
Meepo
man.
Just poofs
he
out.
Blinks and then poofs on top.
Yep.
He's good to go.
And a Haste Rune down bottom, so everybody else will just scurry away.
And Shrine is back up, man. It's time to go. They're going to go again, probably, with CB in like 30 seconds.
What a time to be a Dota player, dude. You can take a fight like that, hit the Shrine, smoke up, and just run right at him again.
I think they're trying to do Roche now. They know that there's like a second, but they didn't know the Shrine was up, so there's going to be some kind of...
They know
this is happening. So they're running at them. They might get the kill. The stomp comes out in time. The Static Storm onto three as well. The Kinetic Field. The Poofs are going to come in here in a moment as well. They're going to get everybody down. Can they get the Aegis? They get the Aegis.
Snatched.
It's snatched. They get the Roche kill on the Dire side.
TA gets the Aegis. She comes back to life. And now Radek will fall. Gets bursted down, but it costs Jiang his life. Meet Your Bob. Blast and Illuminate. But Meepo, he blinks over. They'll catch the Rubick.
God.
And it's about to be another five-man wipe. Glimpse back. Keeper of the Light will fall. Another 1-for-5. They get credit for the Roche, and they finish off the Aegis that TA snatched. It's
Meepo,
another
Disruptor Gaming, man.
Very convincing fight. Yeah, that was a sick combo, dude. That was...
What a blink in. What a blink stomp.
Mod, I think that's what they say, Buck Nasty.
They were not expecting the Shrine. Like, they're like, okay, well, everybody's at half HP, so we can just take Roche now. And then they Shrine up, and like, well, it's time to go kill these guys. They were so close. If that Shrine doesn't exist or if that Shrine's not up, that's their Roche for sure. And they can get out cleanly. But
yeah, I mean, you said it right in the draft. It's not that often that a team fifth picks Meepo and then just gets rolled.
I will say, and I think there's a chance for them to come back, but like they're giving him a lot now.
It's getting scary. I mean, that's a pretty nasty roller coaster. Meepo working on his second Dragon Lance actually has the gold for it, but considering his options, Aghanim Scepter, not nearly as good as it used to be since they changed the stat sharing, but still an option. I think that's more maybe like a fifth slot type item.
Yeah, usually you want to get another Dragonlance. Eye of Skadi is always a big choice at this point in time.
I've
or
seen
Hex.
Some, yeah, Hex be prioritized quite a bit too.
Yeah, Hex is like the new thing.
Hex also has pretty good stats. That's just something people forget about.
Yeah, Ultimate Orb included. You also get some mana out of it, intelligence. But
yeah, I mean, Meepo has some, he has a little bit of mana concerns. Earthbind, Poof. That's one of the reasons why Skadi is quite nice as well.
I mean, to be honest with you, whatever he builds, short of something ridiculous, like it should be fine. He's already ahead as it is. I don't know if they really need the Hex because they have Disruptor Glimpse
and stuff
like that.
Blink E-Blade, that's the item build.
Is it?
I don't know.
I mean, that's actually been you're not wrong, it's been picked up.
It's not crazy, but he might do it. Jiang gets caught again. No Blink Dagger, no mobility. Tries to pop the Disruptor, but it's not enough damage. 90 HP.
Somebody run in there and try to kill that Disruptor. Come on now. Meepo's like the bodyguard.
That's a huge kill, though, dude. TA is the only one really keeping them in this game. Position 1 Venge already starting to feel like she's falling behind.
I mean, if they get Ethereal Blade on this Meepo, they're already dying quickly. I don't really know. It's also good to save against the TA. Ethereal Blade some of your allies just to get, like, the Centauri gets caught.
Mm-hmm.
Get started, hit up by the Desolator, then all of a sudden you just got that Ethereal Blade, you're good to go. So it's both good offensively and defensively.
Ponies. Oh, backdoor protection.
Here comes the Creep Wave. Yeah, they have Golem back up. They have Golem back up. So if you walk out here and you're, like, in a bad position for Slice and Ice, then this is just a bad fight for them.
A little bit of time still on the Static Storm, but they could definitely take a fight without it. Whoops. Take a look at Radiant Vision. They are totally blind right now. Not a single ward down on the map. Dire, they've got a little bit more kind of middle-of-the-map type wards. We'll probably see them start to take control of this enemy jungle, you know, starve them out. And this is the point in the game where if they can keep the Radiant kind of like locked in this quadrant, then they'll just out-farm them. You know, they're not really in a big hurry to close this out. Meepo can just soak up that farm like a vacuum, man. He's like the Auric holding the 6-pound bowling ball.
You know, that's true, but also you do have high ground defense from the Radiant team. I mean, there's Swap, there's Illuminate, TA can jump people if they get caught out of position. Like, if the Jug is trying to spin and take down a tower, he gets swapped, and all of a sudden he's dead.
Yep.
So they need to be careful with how they approach high ground. They still have two tier 2 towers that they want to take down.
Old Yuggy gets his Manta.
Yeah, it's pretty big. It's pretty big.
Look out, Jafar. Aladdin's coming for you.
It's another way to choke out the map, just to have the Manta illusion split push. Now the question is where they will go, like Maelstrom or Diffusal after this.
God, dude, look at that, though. That's like all of Coddle's HP, and it just tickles the Centaur. Omni Slash!
God.
Abed just couldn't save him. Now the Meepo comes in, borrowed time immediately. Jafar gets glimpsed back into the Static Storm kinetic field. They'll bring down the Abaddon, and Jafar looks like he'll go down also as the rock rains from the heavens. Meanwhile, on the other side, Meepo. Oh, he had a double damage rune, too. That's good.
That's nice.
That's great.
Yeah, well, he already has this Ethereal Blade, and he's already working on what seems to be.
Holy shit,
style.
He actually went E-Blade. I called it.
Yeah, you were right. I thought that's what you were saying.
But
you saw quick by.
That makes. Oh, no, I didn't. That makes up for all those kills I missed. I know one thing about Meepo.
Yeah, you got it, man. You're in.
You're in there. Oh, down bottom, there's swimwear happening. Jiang TP's out. Okay.
Yeah, he's gone. Yeah, we're just.
Classic. Man. Tank it with the Golem. Easy Siege. Tier 2 goes the way of HFZ.
Buddy, I don't know about that.
Uh-oh, Ruby Tuesday getting aggressive.
Fatal Mons. Oh, they might actually get this kill here.
Oh, big damage from TA. And Stampede.
That actually is so huge they don't have detection.
That was clutch. TP Glimmer.
Yeah. Manta, swap back, Blade Fury. He doesn't have Aegis, remember. He is very low.
I think Jug is dead here. He should be at least.
Yeah, he's... Maybe
Mist
dead.
Coil, one
oh
more,
my God,
stomp
maybe
on
not.
Three. Oh, no, TA does finish him off as she makes it to the high ground. Does have that Blink Dagger now, but the follow-up is here,
she's
and Meepo is just taking him out. No, they burned it right when Roche went down. The E-Blade is not right. Enough. Meepo dies.
He gets an Ultra Kill. Okay.
Yes, he almost gets the Rampage, so I guess we can't be too upset. Another Glimmer Cape used. Well done by Sid. I just realized that his name is Sid.
Mm-hmm.
Very clever.
S1D. That's what I've been calling him.
Yep. Classification.
My friend S1D.
S1D. Or just my boy Sid.
Sid's way better.
Sydney. Well, I wish I clicked on that team fight recap because I bet TA got a big chunk of cash for that.
2.8K.
That's pretty good. Just picked up the Blink Dagger. But it really just kind of stops the bleeding temporarily. It's a Band-Aid solution. It's still a massive lead for the Dire.
I wonder if she goes BKB.
It's just not great against Meepo, though. The little Earth Binds go... it doesn't go through it anymore.
Nope.
Oh, my. I forgot. That changed.
So they have... I mean, he still has a lot of auto-attack damage with Geostrike, but...
Yes, you're right.
But also my...
No, I think the BKB has got to be pretty tempting. Here we go. Down bottom.
God, you are not split pushing, my friend.
Robert Johnson.
Yeah, he's dead. So they have one tier 2 tower to take. If they can hold on to that for a little while... Slice and Ice could maybe be in an okay position, but
yeah, I mean the thing about Meepo, if you kill him and you can force him to buy back and he dies again, he's out of the game for so long because of the experience differential. Like he's almost level 25, he's level 23 just about. He's gonna get a Manta style. Interesting.
Yeah, I'm wondering about that. Why Manta out of all things? I think you could poof to the illusions. I'm pretty sure.
Oh, probably. That's kind of cool though. Uh-oh, Jug. Going blow for blow with TA.
She needs to leave. She needed to leave a while ago.
Out comes the healing
she
kitty.
She should have a blink.
Glimpse.
Yeah, that's not how that works.
Oh, no.
It's soon as Sid shows up, he's like, okay, this is why she needs a BKB.
Yep. Yeah, forget about the stupid Earthbinds. Like, that alone, that I think probably half of her deaths have been from the Disruptor combo. TA has died five times.
The Disruptor pick was so good. I mean, I feel like they'd be doing well even without Meepo.
At least two of the deaths on TA are from the Disruptor. Yeah, I agree. This is not just a Meepo type. This could be any hero, like any mid. You know, if this was a Windranger right now, I think they could still be in the same position.
Right.
Or Queen of Pain, anyone else that could have made those similar rotations.
So
look how far out this Coddle is, man. This guy is one ballsy ass farmer.
He really wants his Ags. But and keeping them pushed back toward their tier one tower will force some TP rotations. You can already see the Meepo's over there. He's like, he knows the Illuminate's gonna come out. He's about to find him. He's
hey,
all
this Bobby.
Room too. Oh god, meet
oh,
you Bobby.
Oh Bobby. Bobby baby.
See you later, dude. God.
I mean, it's a noble effort. To be fair, at this stage of the game, you got to take some risk. He
could've, oh, for sure.
He could have bought before he died, saved himself a little bit.
I mean, they force everybody back from mid. So they, I don't think they want to go high ground anyway. Though,
they're probably mages. Waiting next rush. Look, they've already got the courier just chilling.
So for those of you that are just joining us here, this is the grand finals of the open qualifiers for the Zotac Cup. Winner of this series will move on into the regional qualifiers and then get a chance, I believe, at the LAN.
Mm-hmm. So it
also
goes
money on the line
open qualifiers, then regional qualifiers, then LAN. But there's some like 24 open qualifiers across all the regions. So there's a lot of opportunities for amateur teams to get some spotlight in this tournament, which is one of the cool things about it.
And if you are a team that would like to be in these regional qualifiers, go ahead and sign up on the opens for. And then I think there's another one, or is this the last one?
For Europe, this well, so there are two for Europe. So there's eight opens total. This is the third one of the eight. So there will be plenty more Europes to come. And there is an NA qualifier as well as a South American qualifier tomorrow that is still open. You can find the link under Twitch.
Yep. Telekinesis, match missile, dead. See you later.
Okay.
That might. The thing is, if Roche was up there, they could probably take it.
Yeah. It's unfortunate timing. Meanwhile, they're BKB. Fighting TA. BKB gets used. Stampede away.
And they buy back on the Warlock.
Well, he has Golem, so probably worth it here. Oh, Meepo, he's still fighting.
This. I don't know about this. Meepo's taking a lot of damage right now.
Yeah, but TA does not have BKB. There's the Omni Slash Jafar. He's getting low. Centaur comes in, brings down the Rubick on the backside. It's a 2-0 to start things off, and now Sigma looks to TP home. He's got the borrowed time, but they've got a rock.
They glimpsed him, too, so they didn't even need to use the rock.
Yeah. Well, better safe than sorry. They can take the rock into Roche, I think, maybe?
It's not up yet again. It's like still a minute away.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Which, again, is very frustrating.
It's a bummer.
The TA surviving, though, is the most important part about these fights. Like, she can't afford to die, really.
That makes the Warlock buyback worth it. You know, they clean it up. It does not secure them Roche, however, and in fact, it could prevent them from getting Roche because all these heroes will be up right around the time Roche respawns, and the only difference is none of the ultimates are available for the Dire, and of course, the Golem being the big one there, but oh, geez. Aghanim Scepter up on the Centaur.
He doesn't care that it's 10% net difference. It's 40% now.
Dude, he gives no shits. And Radiant Courier Meepo was picked off. It. Let's take a look what was on it.
That's the Dire one, I think.
Hyperstone for the TA.
I think she's going AC, I'm pretty sure. I believe.
I mean, it's got to be.
Yeah, she's going AC.
If she was going Moonshard mod, I swear to God.
I need that attack speed. Listen, forget about armor. Attack speed's where it's at.
I mean, Moonshard's an awesome item, but as like a... third slot after BKB. I'm not sure that's a game winner.
Okay, so they know this is happening, but the thing is, there's a Solar Crest Meepo. Mm-hmm. There was a trap in the pit.
Yep.
It might do this quicker than the Radiant team does. They both do it so fast.
The Solar
it's actually
Crest
ridiculous.
Such a
Solar Crest Meepo is actually so stupid when it comes to being able to take Roche.
Yeah.
It's like not even fair.
Well, Roche is dead. Meepo gets the Aegis.
They have Diffusal Blade for the Juggernaut too, which is pretty big.
Yuggy. Yeah, it ups his damage so much after he has the Manta. It's pretty insane, actually.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, the next 5 minutes, I would imagine they try to attempt taking high ground.
Yeah. It's a pretty sufficient lead for the Dire. 15K net worth.
Do they have Ags on the Coddle? Because that heal would be huge if they do
I
have
believe
it.
They do.
Yeah, so that's a giant item for them.
Kotal! Kotal!
Now, this is... Yep. I think this is
it's
still
a big
doable.
High ground defense item. I mean, they can stall this game out for a long time, but they are progressively falling behind. I guess the good news is Meepo's not quite capped out, but he's getting there. He's level 25, so that part doesn't change. Now he'll start finishing up items, but he's going to run into slot issues very soon. dump that Dragon Lance for probably a hex.
I imagine we see a Meepo ban regardless of the outcome of this game from either side. I would imagine that if you're slicing this, you ban it.
This is game one of the best of three series, folks. So it's not marked up top, but this is a BO3.
Always those last pick, like Alchemists or Meepos or Nagas, that just they just crush you, man. But this could be huge. If Smoke is going to come out, they're going to find them, swap in. They have that good vision coming out. Mad in trouble. The Magic Missile, they blow him away, but now here comes Meepo. The Stampede is up as well. Omni Slash, which was stolen, doesn't do much damage. They still want Zhang. He has the Aegis, and he's about to go down, but here's the Golem coming off cooldown as well. S1D, Sid actually, he's got that Static Storm up onto two, but they only get this borrowed time up Abaddon. They're not doing that great so far. It's a one for two as they get the kill on the Coddle. Jafar is back in. They have another Stomp ready to go in a moment. They miss the Earthbind. Sid is going to go down to the Wave of Terror, but Jafar will still fall here more than likely as Zhang is already back at the base. A double kill, and it looks what to be a triple kill potentially for XX.
Yep.
And my Wild doing a great job there.
Well, Aegis of the Immortal Maw, that was pretty much the ideal way for that fight to start from the Radiant perspective.
It's the perfect initiation, that
you
swap
full
kill.
To zero the Jug before he does pretty much anything, and they still can't take the fight. It's a 3-for-4, the Aegis tipping the scales as Meepo comes back to life.
They have very short buyback or respawn timers.
That's true.
I'm not sure. I think the Meepo gets a tier 3. They should have Glyph available for this.
They have no buybacks. There's the Glyph. The problem is when TA doesn't have BKB, she cannot fight. It's down for another 12 seconds. It's an 8-second charge.
I think they get the tier 3, and that's maybe all they get. Oh, the blinding light. So good. They might not even get this. The Mantis style comes out. I think this tier 3 is alive.
It is. Okay.
So that could have gone way worse for Slice and Dice.
Power of the High Ground. At least it's sort of a break-even fight. Again, stalls this game out just a little bit longer. The longer it goes on, the less that massive net worth lead matters.
Now, this is starting
and
to get interesting.
And Scotty up on Meepo.
That's huge. Armor.
Of course, Hex on the way.
Yeah, if you can get the Blink Hex off on the TA before she BKBs, then it's pretty much a kill. The Jug is starting to look very, very squishy against this Venge. Venge is like the perfect counter to Juggernaut. With Wave of Terror, swap out is very important. And if you get level 25, Magic Missile through immunity is huge against the Juggernaut. So he can't just Blade Fury out and do whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets stunned up. And like, oh, God, it's so useful. I was playing Core Venge the other day. I've been talking to Trent about this. First of all, Hurricane Pike first. He did, I think, go for the Drums first, but, like, Hurricane Pike is such a good item.
Mm-hmm.
It actually does so much for you in terms of positioning, finding swaps, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's only level 16, though, so he's a little under-farmed.
It's pretty brutal. I mean, think about how this mid-game went. This Venge did not get a lot done. It was mostly just a defensive posture. And that's a hero all about momentum. She really doesn't farm particularly fast, and when you don't have a lot of space on the map, there's not a hell of a lot she can do. Mid lane, do they find some initiation here? Centaur, mana leaked, blinding lighted, swapped back, stampede,
he's
where's
so
it at?
Tanky, but he's gonna maybe survive here. Oh, I can't believe. I think they solar crested him too.
Yep.
So they had some mischances there, and now Jafar is dead again, it looks like. He tried to force himself out with a Hurricane Pike. Upheaval is there, they're trying to heal him with the Static Storm to zone everybody else out, so he's dead for 3.
No buyback.
Yeah.
Brutal stuff, man. It looked like a free kill on the Centaur. That's like as jebaited as it gets.
Look at that healing ward. Oh, my God. And the Shadow Ward on top of it, too.
Yeah,
he's back at full HP.
Completely. So a big pickoff there. Again, 30 seconds, 4v5 on the field. They still have the Rock. The only thing they don't have is Static Storm. Even Stampede, a pretty short cooldown at this stage of the game.
Mana leak Telekinesis. They can't bring him up to the high ground. They tried, though. It was very close. Needed to be like a half step further down to the south.
Yeah. He had Manta, Glimmer Cape, Sid doing so much work with that Glimmer Cape, honestly.
He's had a great game, like those Static Storms. Even if he only catches one, it's like always a big hero they're catching.
Yeah. No
but
Glyph.
Blade Fury, and he could just do this because there isn't a swap. Now they have to BKB on Zhang. He's going to go man mode, man fighting here. Refractions back up and won the Golem. He won't be able to get it off. He's dead for 80. No buyback. Borrow time already used. TP coming out from Sigma.
That might be game, dude.
Yeah,
there it is.
Like it. Wow.
TA calls it. No buyback available. Before the Scotty, she was able to go man mode against the Meepo with the BKB on.
God.
And you could see the difference that time. Meepo just straight up won the battle.
That's like gotta be so frustrating for them to just lose that. To like the fifth pick Meepo comes out and you just audibly groan, I would imagine. You're just like, well, what do we do now?
Yeah. Because you know, at that point, you know what's going to happen. And it is literally the 10th pick of the match, so you've lost that ability to counter it. 15-45, the graph tells a pretty accurate tale. Never a moment was Slice and Dice ahead in this game.
There were moments that they were like, okay, we can maybe get back into this, and it might have looked bad for HFZ, but they were able to just corral it.
Pretty classic Meepo game. I will say very impressive performance from Jiang on the TA.
Yeah.
Laned well against the Meepo. I don't think he died solo. I guess they traded once. We missed it, but they went one for one. But overall, that's a matchup where if the TA doesn't play perfectly, Meepo can start to really just pick on him. You know, in lane, the Nets are super strong.
I mean, Jen just didn't have a lot of control around him to deal with the Meepo because, like, they want more AoE damage, and all they have is a TA, and, like, I guess the Illuminate from the Coddle. Like, you pick somebody like a Magnus with Empower and, like, a Sven or something on top of that, and you just blow the Meepo away with, like, God Strength, like, Empower, like, kind of combos.